Orange. Yep, this one's definitely orange. Green? I need to keep trying. The fun colors, the crispy outer shell, the delicious chocolatey centers. Ugh, it's no wonder this delicious candy has become a classic treat that I've already eaten an entire pound of today. Get ready to make your dentist mad, because today we're talking about what they got right with M&M's.
Crunchy, colorful, chocolatey delight, we talking M&M's, this is what they got right!
The Mars Company first came out with M&M's in 1941. All of the colors have the exact same flavor. The colors are basically just for fun. They also make it easier for me to find them. But did you know that they stopped making red M&M's for 10 years? A study published in the early 70s linked red dye 2 to cancer, and understandably, everyone got a little freaked out. In response, they stopped manufacturing red M&M's. The crazy part? M&M's weren't even made with red dye 2. But the public was so scared of anything red that they got rid of them just to ease everyone's nerves. The silver lining to this red disaster was that M&M introduced the orange candy in its place.
This one right there.
You're probably thinking, but Ruby, red M&M's are a thing. You're right, and that's because the color was reintroduced in 1987, when all the controversy had died down. Don't worry, they kept orange in there too, which is awesome because I use both. While we're on the subject of color, the makers at M&M got another thing right by getting rid of a certain color, and that color was tan. Yup. Tan was added to the M&M family in 1949, replacing violet. But with happy hues like red, yellow, and green, it was hard to justify having a color that was reminiscent of, oh, I don't know, a leather couch. They got rid of them in 1995 and held a vote to see whether pink, purple, or blue would join the ranks as the newest shade. One color blew the others out of the water for the winning spot. The colors aren't the only thing to change. The M&M's we know and love are stamped with an M. But back when they first came out, they were totally blank. That's crazy! Without the stamp, how would you distinguish it from another candy-coated fruit treat that's pretty popular these days?
No, I'm allergic to artificial fruit flavoring.
They added the M in 1950, and the lowercase letter became a symbol of deliciousness. Maybe the biggest travesty of all time is that crispy M&M's almost didn't exist. The world was blessed with crispy M&M's in 1999, but it was supposed to be a limited edition flavor. So in 2005, they discontinued it in the US. I lived for 10 years with an epic flavor of M&M's out there that I couldn't try. But after a decade of so many people begging the Mars Company to bring back the crispy M&M's, they reintroduced the beloved product in 2015, and now I can enjoy it from the comfort of my own home. The original flavor of M&M's may have originally been called plain, but I promise you that there is nothing plain about these legendary chocolate buttons. Through some colorful changes, they've become some delicious candies that have helped me spoil many dinners over the years. Thanks for watching What They Got Right. What should I talk about next? Let me know below the comment. Then, click up there to subscribe to DreamWorks TV for new videos every single day. Until next time,
I think I have a stomach ache. Totally worth it.